unconnected, completely unclutched. You connect, you collect some flowers, some thoughts, and create a shaft about yourself. If you create, I am a saint, you hold on to that shaft. If you create a shaft, I am a sinner, you hold on to that shaft. You create some shaft about yourself, some idea connecting these thoughts. If you create a shaft that your life is pain, you try to break it. If you create a shaft, something is joy, then you try to elongate that shaft. Whether your effort to elongate or you are trying to break, both are going to be failure because the very shaft doesn't exist. Please understand this one important thing. How your mind is working, only then we'll be able to go into the meditations. Whether it's a shaft, for example, the pain which happened to you 10 years ago, the pain which happened 9 years ago, the pain which happened 8 years ago, the pain which happened yesterday, they are complete independent incidents. They have no link, but mentally you give link to all that pains and you start thinking you are having the same pain, including your physical pains. Please understand, when I say, I mean including your physical pains, not only your mental pains, even physical pains. The pain which you experienced 1 month ago, the pain which you experienced 1 week ago, the pain which you experienced yesterday, all three are different, independent thoughts or independent experiences. When you start connecting them mentally and create an idea, you are having back pain continuously, you are having headache continuously, you are having this suffering continuously. You decide, yes, I have this suffering, I have this problem, now I have to solve. You try to solve. You can never solve because the very shaft doesn't exist. The very idea you have this problem is a lie. It's an independent, separate happenings. You are trying to connect. Same way, 10 years ago the sweet which you enjoyed and the joy which you felt. 9 years ago the sweet which you enjoyed and the joy you felt. 1 year ago the sweet which you enjoyed, the joy you felt. They are independent happenings. If you try to create a shaft, that sweet gives me joy, you will start creating hell for yourself. Because the moment you create the shaft, two things. One, whenever you want joy, you will try to have sweet. But the big problem is that same sweet will not be giving you the same joy every time. So naturally you will have frustration. Naturally you will have frustration. One, first thing, you will try to elongate that joy shaft and it will be a failure. Next thing, you will try to replace the same product for that joy. Again, a failure. Both the way, you will be a big failure. You can't elongate that shaft. Same way, you can't try to break the shaft of pain. Whether it is pain or joy, you can't do anything about it. Sometimes suddenly you will feel joyful, excited, alive for no reason. Sometimes suddenly you will feel low, dull, depressed for no reason. It is completely independent. It is completely illogical. It is completely unclutched. What is happening in your mind is neither related to the personality or identity which you are showing to the outer world, nor related to the identity which you are showing to yourself. Both are completely unclutched. You are neither connected with this, nor connected with that. The big thing, the moment you start hearing this truth, tremendous fear rises in you. Then what am I? What is going on in me? Then what for I was running all these years? The big fear, you see, your whole life is invested. Your whole life is invested on this one idea. You are connected, continuous being. When I shake that very root, all sorts of fear happens in you. It is difficult to believe. It is difficult to understand. You start going crazy. Actually, if you don't go crazy, then you are doing something seriously wrong. If you don't go crazy after listening to this truth, be very clear, you have not understood. When you really understand the truth, when you start digesting it, when you start working with the truth, something will start happening in you. You can't imagine what is going on. You will be completely shaken. Let it be very clear. Vivekananda says beautifully, whatever can be washed away, let it be washed away from your being. The earlier they are washed away, better for you. The earlier they are washed away, better for you. Whatever can die, let it die. Whatever can't die, it will not die. Whatever can die in you, let it die. Now there are so many things, whether the shaft of pain or the shaft of joy, all the shaft, constantly you are creating the shaft by your imagination. Constantly you are creating the shaft because you have your vested interest in that. See, mind means nothing but generalizing. Mind wants to keep all your experiences in a memory. So all the joyful memories you put in one file and keep it in one side. All your painful experiences you put in one file and keep it in another side. For filing it is okay, but not for reality. For filing purpose, okay. You can file. Yes, this sweet means joy. Put it in that file. But by and by, you start believing that as an existential truth. In the initial level, you started filing just for the sake of remembrance, just for the sake of easy handling. After some time, you start believing that sweet is directly related to the joy, that act is directly related to that pain, that act is directly related to that joy. When you start connecting in that way, be very clear, you created hell for you. You created hell for you. Then naturally you are behind that act again and again. Neither that act gives you fulfillment, nor it gives you satisfaction. And even if it doesn't give you satisfaction, because of your faith, it will give you satisfaction. You try to run behind it. Sometime even after knowing that sweet is not giving you any joy anymore, you don't want to give it up, because these few things which you feel, which you have faith, which you think is the juice of your life, only those few things are the base for your life. If that is also not there, what for you will run? Why should you get up from the bed? What for you should be alive? You start questioning the basic existence. But let you be very clear, even questioning basic existence is right. Even that is right thing, then running behind something which has no solid base. Once you decide this is joy, once you start believing, creating a shaft, this is joy, after that, even if it doesn't give you joy, just because you decided, you don't want to give it up, you don't want to drop that, you don't have that much of courage or honesty to review your decisions. First thing which you need to be born as a new person, to take a spiritual birth, is the capacity to doubt. Be very clear. Constantly you are taught, constantly the idea to believe is given. Be very clear, now it is time to doubt all your decisions. Whatever you have decided about your joy, about your pain, about your life, about your death, including your death. Actually, if you understand this one truth, death is nothing. Because every moment you are dying, every thought is unclutched. Where is the question of death? Where is the question of death? Every thought is unclutched. Your fear doesn't have any place in your inner space. All your fear is nothing but one more shaft. When something happened, you responded to that incident, to that moment, with a particular kind of emotion. And now, you are afraid that same kind of incident will repeat. You will have the same kind of emotion. But that time what happened, and now what is happening, both are completely independent incidents. They are two separate things. When you start connecting them with your imagination, you start creating more and more troubles for you. Let me be very clear. First thing, believing you have a solid mind is the greatest myth. Mind is myth. Whatever you think as you is a pure myth. Your identity which you are carrying is a pure myth, because it gives you paycheck, because it gives you social comfort, because it gives you an idea about yourself. You do not want to let go. You are afraid of opening yourself. Even now, whatever I am saying, your mind says, yes, whatever he says is right. It can't be lie. But for practical purpose, let me not bother about all these things now. You just want to keep all these things away. Because you know it will shake you. It will shake all your actions, or the way in which you think, the way in which you function. Your whole being will be shaken if you allow this truth inside your inner space. You are afraid. You are afraid of this whole thing. How can I be an unclutched being? How can me be like this? Then what am I? You built your identity, spending your whole life. Your identity, which you are showing to others, you spent your whole life to build that. The same way, identity which you are carrying within yourself, you have spent so much of energy to build that. You have spent so much of energy to build these two identities. Now I am saying, suddenly somebody is coming from Bangalore and saying, that doesn't exist. It is something like, he is taking away your whole life. He is taking away something which you built, spending your whole life. But let you be very clear, I am not taking away anything from you, because whatever you think you are having is a pure myth. It's a pure myth. You are carrying a belief in you which is not even giving you peace and joy. If it gives you peace and joy, I have nothing against it. Carry, be happy, be blissful, no problem. But it is not giving you that. It is not giving you peace or bliss. Let it be very clear. I tell you from my experience, I have never seen a person who feels complete with the identity which he is projecting to the outer world, or with the identity which he is projecting towards himself. With the outer world, no question, even Bill Gates won't feel satisfied. Even he feels threatened by competitors. Same way with the identity which you are showing towards yourself, even the great saints don't feel that they are complete. Let you be very clear. I have met so many saints, or so-called saints. They don't feel they are complete. You can't feel you are complete, because even if you try to be pure, try to be perfect, try all the practices which you can do, not for 25 years, even for 50 years, again you will have the same mind. Because mind which you are trying to chisel doesn't exist. If it exists, then you can chisel and make as you want and keep as you want. That base itself doesn't exist. That shaft itself doesn't exist. Then what will you do? You can't do anything about it. You can't develop your mind. Training your mind is simply impossible because the mind doesn't exist. You don't have a continuous shaft. If you have a continuous shaft, then either you can elongate or break or do whatever you want. But there is no continuous shaft. You are just made to believe you have continuous shaft. You have an identity. Your identity which you are showing to the outer world, your identity which you are carrying towards yourself, these two are the greatest thieves who steal your whole life. The superior ego which you are showing to the outer world, the inferior ego with which you are fighting constantly within yourself. These two doesn't exist because every moment your thoughts are independent. You can read that notebook and understand. They are no way logically connected to each other. Try to read, you will understand. Suddenly you are having a thought, let me go to India. And second thought, let me go and see that movie. Third thought, no, let me attend this camp properly. Swamiji is telling something. Third thought, yes, no work, he has come here and he is sitting and talking. Who knows what is truth and what is not. The fourth thought, nowhere related to this. Suddenly you will think, why not go to Universal Studio and see a movie. Nothing will be connected. Suddenly you will think, no, I could have gone to my job today, at least I would have had a little money. What am I doing sitting here? And the fourth thought, what my next person is writing? He is smiling, what is going on? And no way it is connected to each other. See, nothing is connected to each other. Simply so many things are happening, just like that bubbles, the water bubbles in the fish tank, just like the things are happening. You are afraid to see the whole spectrum. You are afraid to see the whole thing which is happening in you. Just because of that fear, you pick up, you choose only few things and connect, create a garland, and you keep a small space or a limited thing and start associating yourself with that. Just by knowing that small shaft, you think, oh, I know everything now. Let you be very clear. You can't take specimen thoughts out of your mind because there is no generalization possible. If generalization is possible, you can take a specimen. Specimen of good thoughts, specimen of bad thoughts. But no generalization is possible. You are just loose flowers. Loose flowers. Be very clear. You are complete loose flowers. But when you don't understand that, you try to develop. You think you are a garland. You try to add some color flowers which you like. Or you try to remove some color flowers which you don't like. You are sitting and playing with it. Let you be very clear. You can never change your mind. If you are playing with the mind, you can transform your mind. Changing is not possible. Transforming is possible. When I say the word transform, I mean you can just be completely out of it. When you understand, you are completely unclutched. All the impact created on your inner space by the thoughts, guilt, fear, desire, greed, whatever impact created on you by your thoughts will disappear. Suddenly you will feel you are out of all these things. Your desire has no base because your ideas about joy is just a shaft which you are creating, which has no base. Your fear has no base because the idea of fear is which you are creating, that shaft which you are creating by connecting, which has no base. Your guilt has no base. Your morality has no base. Your immorality has no base. Nothing has any base. Let you be very clear, because again and again you are creating a shaft.